Hey everyone, just wanted to do a real quick video and show you how to not do metalwork. So you could see some of the interesting and fun things we get to do here at the shop, fixing and repairing other people's bad work. We tend to get a lot of this type of work here. I think it's, one, because we do things correctly. We fix things correctly. We do it the right way. And a lot of people just don't, they skip over stuff because it might be too hard, or maybe they just don't know any better. I don't know. But this one's definitely an interesting one. So I haven't really spoken with the owner yet, so I'm not going to go into details about what the car is and put that out there. But basically, it's a really awesome antique Japanese sports car. The rest of the car is great. Panel fitment, paint, the interior, the engine bay, really an awesome car. And this is just the one area that somebody really skipped out on at one point in the car's life, and it has to be corrected now. He is trying to sell the car, and people love it, but as soon as they look underneath, they tell him nah, and they walk away. And so that's kind of the problem he's having, and he has people that would buy it if it was fixed properly. So that's why the car's here. We're gonna fix it properly and get this thing back to where it should be. So let me show you underneath here, and you can see the wonderful work that's been done. So basically, both the driver and passenger frame rail is totally crunched in, totally rotted, and this was all filled with body filler. You didn't even see that it looked like this. we just started poking around and looking, and we uncovered these frame rails. So it's hard to see on film here, but it is totally atrocious. And you can see body filler just keeps going back. We just kept poking at it with a screwdriver, and I'm sure that goes all the way back to here. You can see these ugly boogered welds here. Somebody put a floor pan in and didn't bother doing spot welds. They just figured they'd tack it in place and call it a day, and it's just ugly, and it's terrible. And you can see the floor pan here, where they did a couple of patch jobs. I don't even know what they did, but up here, I can break these welds off just by hand with a screwdriver. So this is just really bad. So we're gonna do two full floor pans, front to back, both driver and passenger side, as well as the floor braces, and we got frame rails as well. So all this is gonna be taken out and changed and done correctly. A little bit of a challenge doing this on a finished vehicle like this, but it has to be done, and we can do that. So I'm gonna show you a couple of the spots here, and then we'll be done. So here's the rear of the floor pan, and you can just see, I don't know what's going on, but there's patches on patches, and they didn't know how to make anything fit, and I don't know what they were doing. Here again, I can just go ahead and peel this floor pan right apart. So you can see on this side, we've already put the new floor pan in. We got the thing fit in place, and we're starting to weld it together. So it already looks 100 times better. Nothing's been finished grinded, so there's actually still a lot of work left to do under here to make it look pretty. You can see we got the frame rail in, and then over here we actually had to fabricate this tow board in-house here, because that was all rotted once we took it apart and had nothing to weld the floor pan to. So it's gonna be so much nicer, a much, much better job. And when it's all said and done, you'll never even know that we changed them. It'll look factory.